If you exist in the world, you've probably noticed the cost of almost everything is on the rise.
I'm spending more money on food.
Every time you tip that you get in the car, it's like more money down the drain.
We're finding it very, very hard.
Today, the Australian Bureau of Statistics validated that pain, revealing overall inflation is up 5.1% over the past year.
This is a lot more than even most economists were expecting. To see it with a 5 in front of it really emphasises just how much pressure there's been.
Yep, whatever milk or bread you're into.
Multigrain, sourdough, are we just going to be the ones that come from dairy or is it the almond?
They're all bloody expensive. Food going up 4.3%.
It's actually breaking the bank. Every week it's there's $30 in the difference of us shopping.
Just trying to survive.
But transport and housing costs are the real eye-waterers, up 13.7% and 6.7% respectively. And the squeeze is about to get a whole lot tighter, with some economists now tipping a rate rise as soon as this Tuesday.
One of the Reserve Bank's key jobs is to keep a lid on inflation, but they don't have many levers they can pull, and the biggest one is to increase interest rates.
Naturally, other Western countries have similar inflation worries, but while New Zealand has upped its interest rates 4 times since August, we haven't raised ours in 11 years.
But there's Australia, performing better than all of them when it comes to cost of living pressures. Now, that hasn't happened by accident.
But you can bet Labor doesn't see it that way.
This inflation number should be a wake-up call for a government which is out of touch, out of plans and out of time.
The RBA either raise rates next week and they're seen as interfering in the election, or because everyone expects them to raise rates at their June meeting, they do it after the election and they're seen as interfering in the election.
The last time the RBA raised interest rates during an election campaign was in 2007, just before the GFC. Combined with the K-Rudd charm offensive, many experts believe it contributed to John Howard's defeat. So if rates do go up, what's it mean for this lot? And more importantly, what's it mean for you?
There you go, Christopher. That's exactly what you want as a government in an election campaign, isn't it? A record inflation rate.
No, you don't. Mm. You don't want an interest rate rise, which we had in 2007, mm-hmm. when I was still in Parliament. It was so long ago. And but unemployment's coming down. So they say there's a truism in Australian politics that if inflation, unemployment and interest rates are going up, then the government is doomed. But one out of the three are not, so that's interesting. But obviously it's going to be unfortunate for voters, particularly anybody who's a consumer. We don't want to see prices going up. I guess the Prime Minister's pitch is we're doing better than any other country in the G7, mm. And our interest rates haven't gone up in 11 years, and he's hoping to get credit for that. We'll have to wait and see.
But where we aren't going up is wages. Mm. So now you've got a double whammy, right? You've got high inflation and wages are not going anywhere. So you're feeling a double.
But with higher inflation, you will see wages going up. So,
but not in real terms.
In the short term, wages will be where they are. They'll respond to inflation. As you say, they'll only be catching up with inflation. So that is a real pressure point in an election. Mm-hmm. Elections are, you know, like a roller coaster ride. First 2 weeks were good for the government. This week's been a bit tricky.